Hello, hello everyone, and welcome back to Shogun 2, where we are playing as the Shimatsu. So, as I promised, I took a few turns where I just basically managed stuff and waited until something was actually happening. And now there is something happening. Also, there are a few other things that also has been happening. Firstly, I got a trade agreement with these guys. I also got a trade agreement with these guys. And I got an alliance with these guys, and I decided, let's also get military access, fair enough, I got that, and I was going to go after this province right here, and then my allies decided to declare war, and you might say, well, that's not a challenge, is it? Just this province. No, let's take a look at the diplomacy. It's those guys, right? They're also allied with these guys. And they might be a formidable enemy. Right now they have four provinces. Also they are allied with these guys, right here. And that might also be an issue. Anyway, needless to say, my ally definitely needs a bit of help. And of course, as the great ally I am, I'm going to steal this castle from right under their noses. Yeah. So we'll declare war.
Well, I will listen
and
to your words
these guys are already at war with them, so that shouldn't be an issue. There we go. Nice. We're in a great big war. So should we continue the siege? Should we try to break them down? Actually, we probably should try to assault this, seeing that it's actually winter right now, so if we just leave them here, we are going to suffer attrition, and we don't want to do that. So, let's go ahead. Okay, so not really the best weather. Let's wait a little bit. Okay, even worse. Well, okay, snow it is then. I guess it's fair. It's kind of winter up in here. Okay, so obviously, the one advantage we really have over our enemies is the Katana Samurai, which we probably should be trying to rush up as fast as possible. Also, these walls aren't really that tall, except for like here and here. So we might try to climb it, but of course, if we can afford it, when it comes to losses, we can take our time and actually try to burn down this. But yeah, these walls are not that tall. Like here, this should be doable. At least for a few units, like get up there and get into the fight. So yeah, I think I'll be trying to do that. Also, we have loads of archers. We also have a few actual bow samurai. So we will be able to do some damage. Okay, so how many units? If we have four on either side here, well, maybe not four. We'll have two who tries to climb up this wall, and let's see, three up in the center, and then three over here. I think we're actually good. Spear units. Well, I don't really know. I have a few of them. Yeah. This looks pretty decent, actually. Just arrange those guys. And, yeah, let's see. So, many of the defending units are plain Ashigaru units. They have loads of archers, which I'm kind of worried about. At least after the thing I experienced with skirmish units in Rome 2. Yeah, if you saw that episode, you know what I'm talking about. And if you want to see what I'm talking about, so look up the last part of, the latest part, I should say. It's not the last part of my Rome 2 playthrough. Yeah. Anyway, This is Shogun 2, and the mechanics are slightly different. Well, actually quite different. So, I will lead with my archers, but I will very soon put forward my samurai, which have more armor and can therefore actually absorb a few arrows. Which is always great. Okay, this side is undefended. Awesome. So, archers, are you in range? No, not yet. Well, it seems like the enemy archers are in range. I'm taking losses here. Okay then, that should definitely make them being in range. Yes, English, very English. There we go. Let's push you guys up and get you to climbing. Ah, samurai retainers. Okay then. Also, Bohashigaru garrison, they are taking losses. Not that many. Mainly because they are actually well defended in those fortifications. Which is kind of what they're made for. Okay. So one clan up here, one clan up there, and one go and burn this shit. So, in addition to loads of archers, a lot of the garrison is also Yari Shigaru, which, as you might remember, is not that good at all. At least not the standard units. And why am I doing this? Just standing here? Who knows? I certainly don't. Let's see, try to climb up there. Go. So we're actually unopposed on the flanks, but straight up in the middle, we are taking a lot of losses. And we're probably going to lose the samurai units. Which sucks. And also, what are you hitting? It's certainly not a gate. Oh, that wasn't actually... That wasn't supposed to be you. But okay. Oh, here we go. Bohashigaru is retreating, making them an easier target. Always appreciated. Let's see, this is clearly burning, but I still see zero damage. Awesome. Okay. There we go, go against the Yari Samurai, he should be winning that. Yari Ashigaru Garrison. Okay, but right now you're in the background, so let's go ahead and charge Yari units.
From the battlefield! Shameful display!
Yeah. That's fair, I guess. Let's see, I think I want to try to get up over here, even though I will probably take a few losses doing that. Hang on! Allied samurai units to the rescue. Okay, should I just get down to burning this gate immediately? I don't know, might be a good idea. Maybe with this unit? Well, they are coming out again. Very considerate of you, making it easier for me and everything. Yeah, sending Bohashigaru into this might not be the best tactic. But apparently it's doing some work, seeing that these guys, were they red earlier? Yes, they were, and now they are once again. Okay, this is a situation I like. Hadn't it been for all the archer fire. But, well, you can't have everything. Actually, let's try to suppress that a bit. You two on these guys, and you two on those guys. Yeah, this is not going well for the AR units, as suspected. Speaking of AR units, let's get my own into this. Okay, these two are completely breaking. Well, unfortunately, as well as a few of my units. Are they breaking? No, they're not. But somehow I managed to give them a movement order.
Our men are running from the battlefield. Shameful.
Probably the sword unit over here. Yes, the sword unit over here. Run away. Well, he definitely took a lot of damage there, so you're allowed to run, even though I don't necessarily like it. So I sent in two Yari units there. I thought I did, at least. Let's see. Yeah, I did. I thought I sent in the two Ashikari units, but apparently I sent in the Yari Samurai as well.
One of our units has used all its ammunition,
Michael. Okay. Oh yeah, follow them up. That would actually be great. If we manage to do that properly. Okay, this unit shattered. And they had less than 30 guys remaining, so I guess they're allowed to do that. Oh, I haven't moved you up. Well then. Okay, let's try to climb up with these guys and get a few things going. Let's see. Trials to burn out that. Rishikaru, they are wavering. Okay. These sword units, climb.
One of our units has used all its ammunition,
now I guess we can, except for these guys, I guess we can take the remaining units and try to rush them in. This is kind of an all-in attack by now. So therefore we should also be involving our general. So we can actually get a bit of morale out of this. Okay, this is completely, well, not completely, but as good as destroyed. So let's use the ramp we now have, I should say. And get him up there. Our samurai are already doing a good job. There we go, try to capture both things. And do they still have a unit flank? Hard to tell, really. But at least I'm capturing this archery tower. I actually have two archery towers. Nice. Okay, you go for them. I don't want to take point-blank archery fire. At least not with my Ashigari units. I don't think that is a particularly good idea. Okay, this gatehouse is now mine, but I'm a bit occupied right now. Unfortunately. Let's try to get my general over here. Yeah, I think I'm losing this, unfortunately. I don't have that many troops still remaining. I have very good troops still remaining, but I still don't have very many of them. Let's see, those guys are broken. Let's go for the wavering units. Okay, so the problem here is that I'm defeating the garrison units, but at the same time, they have so many of them, and even if they just make a few kills on every single one of my units, they will eventually whittle me down to the point where I actually can't win. And I think I'm kind of reaching that with a lot of the units.
Our men are running from the battlefield.
Certainly with the I was going to say archer units, but I meant not samurai, that's general. Sword units, katana samurai. Okay, finally. Let's get you over there. Okay, I might have a chance, actually. A slight chance, but still a chance. Okay, there we go, General. Rally. Well, that was a bit too late for those guys. That's unfortunate. Who needs morale? I guess you do. We're going to try to keep the Katana unit still active. Because they are the best units I have. Without a doubt. Also, I can stand there and try to cap. Actually, let's try that. And rather jump into the fight with the ones I have quite a lot of.
Our men are running from the battlefield! Shame for this play!
Whoops, that was not what I meant to do. I was just going to try to deselect that, and I guess I did it by doing that. Okay, I see the balance bar is going slightly into our favor again. Just slightly, but I'll take everything I can get at this point. Okay, these guys are going to break almost instantly, I think. Well, almost instantly. Also, this thing is counting down, so even if the forces I had couldn't whittle down the enemy units, I still will win on the cap. So there's that. And there, I actually won. Yeah, there was a point there where I really didn't anticipate that. So, and the battle, a decisive victory. Well, I guess it was decisive in the point that I had way fewer men than the enemy did. And I guess I killed a lot more than they did. But I would say it was more a Pyrrhic victory, because I was kinda hoping that I would have a satisfactory number of men remaining. To the point where I could actually defend as well. But I don't know if that will be happening. Well, it will be happening eventually, but right now I have my doubts. Well, at least I get garrison units, and I can actually stand here and replenish. But as you can see, I have quite a damaged army right now. Which means we need to be recruiting. Yeah. Yeah, let's send up three waves. I don't think I'll have that much time, but anyway, let's try. Also, send up a few bow samurai, and that was actually all I could afford this turn. So yeah, rebuilding this, which is great, because it gives me a repression. Also gives me a few bonuses. Replenishment rate, that's a big one. And does it grant me additional defending units? I seriously hope so. I don't think so. Okay, so as I can see right now, it doesn't seem like I will be attacked by these guys on the very next turn. But if I have the maximum amount of unluckiness, I might get attacked by the army these guys had. Right here, because I saw earlier it was camped on this border right here, and when I saw they left, that was the same turn these guys attacked, and therefore I went on and attacked. Yeah, but hopefully these guys will be able to help me out a bit. So I'll end the turn right here, and I'll see you on the other side of like 5 minutes, because that seems like the amount of time the end turns actually take here. Annoying, I know. Okay, so I didn't get attacked, that's a positive. And then we have two negatives. Well, one, my building was sabotaged, which of course will eat up a lot of koku. But secondly, and maybe more importantly, I got abandoned. They retreated. so I don't have the protection of my allies anymore. But hopefully I will be able to spot the enemy agent, because I have a shinobi. Between episode I built a... what was it? A inn? I think it was a straight inn. And as you can see, I'm building a gambling hall. So yeah, hopefully I will be able to have powerful agents. At least eventually. I'll try to build that up. Also, first wave. Done. So, let's send them up. I might send up the bow ashigari as well. Let's do that. Take everything we can get at this point. On the... yeah, as I said, on the bright side, we didn't get attacked. And hopefully they don't have a strong enough army to actually go ahead and invade me. Hopefully. Keep in mind that, yes, I actually have a few garrison units by now. And also the castle is tiered. Which castle did I defend? I think I defended this one. And at that point, it only had one tier. So, at least it's better than that. So, I'm recruiting a bow samurai unit. And recruiting that. Let's see, right now is not a particularly good idea with cavalry, seeing that I am defending a fort. But in the future, where I might be fighting open field battles, it's probably a good idea. Actually, let's first take a look at what units I can actually recruit here. Oh! Nice. Okay then, I can actually recruit a few units here. Very good. Unless I'm getting attacked, of course, because when you're besieged, you can't recruit units. You probably knew that, but just in case you didn't. So yeah, basically at this point, we're just sitting back and hoping to not get attacked. Until we can actually rebuild our army. So, once again, we are being sabotaged, and one of our units got bribed. Not good. Okay, I don't actually need more generals right now. Might be a good idea later, but not right now. So, first thing, let's hire a Metsuke. You really need that, apparently, because our bow samurai got stolen right under our noses. Okay, so our samurai. 31% success chance. 20% success chance. Well, let's try at least the chance, the biggest chance we have. Assassination failed. Well, it was a 1 in 3 chance, so I guess it's fair. Unfortunately, he will continue on just sabotaging everything. Oh well. So this still hasn't been recruited? What did I... oh yeah, of course, I actually had 4 units under recruitment, and I completely forgot immediately. Fairly typical. And yeah, we are actually gaining... you're getting our reinforcements. Unless they are bribed on the way. That sucks. But, yeah, I'm probably going to try to kill off this guy. Eventually. That might be the highest priority right now. Okay, so this is repaired, and we have a bit of cocoa left. Do you want to really use that on anything? No, I don't think so. But what we want to do is actually pick our research, because right now I research this and then I just let it go to the way of the sea, which I'm not really using that much. But I certainly don't want naval expertise. Not when I can research such things like sword expertise. Okay, it gives me bonsai. Yes. Let's go for that, and in the process we will get Master Dojo, which actually give me pretty awesome cavalry. Let's go for that. That'll take 13 turns. And did I... No, I didn't build that. Let's go ahead and build that. With the money we have left over. And we have yet another Bow Samurai unit. There we go. So yeah, I think we're on good track to rebuild our army, and eventually we should be able to push out and maybe go ahead and capture this. I still haven't seen how big their army is, and I can't really send out a scout because of this guy blocking the way, unless I want to send out several scouts in order to succeed a... well, in order to guarantee a victory right there. But anyway, as I said, I'm building up my army, and I should be able to move out in... well, not a few turns, but not that many turns at least. But until then, I will be doing that personally. And therefore, I will end the episode here. So, I hope you enjoyed this episode. Like, comment, and subscribe if you did. And, as always, I will see you guys next time. Goodbye.